forecast in just about 10 minutes.
Riley, with those cold temperatures overnight, it's hard for some of us to imagine not having a warm place to go. And that's why warming centers are opening up across Augusta. Here's Anna Halliburton with how you can find one.
The easiest way is for you to download our WRDW app. We have all of the city's 11 warming centers listed for you under our top stories. And there are other resources around our area to help those in need escape the cold. Here's a look.
Our men's shelter was full, and our women's shelter was almost at capacity.
The Salvation Army Center of Hope shelter saw a lot of people Tuesday night as temperatures dropped below freezing.
When I first came to Salvation Army, I never knew about the homeless situation in Richmond County. And to see that has been an eye-opener.
Rhodes says it doesn't have to be freezing for people to come in.
A normal day is still pretty full, especially in our men's shelter. The women's shelter, not as much.
They open the door starting at 4 o'clock each day with people getting food, clothing, personal items, and a to-go meal the next morning. Rhodes says you just have to have the need to qualify.
This has provided housing and food for a lot of people over the years.
And if you don't need shelter, organizations like Project Life are available.
People are able to come in and get clothing every 2 weeks, and we also have food as well. People can come in and get food once a month. We are a food pantry with Golden Harvest.
Project Life is a nonprofit organization helping those who need it. Soon they will be expanding to provide educational services.
We just want to be a blessing to our community and let people know that good people do exist, and we just want to help them out.
And people are helping out, too. We found Kashonda Jackson near 13th Street Bridge passing out food.
And I just love giving. It makes my soul rise. It's all I care about. Nothing else I care about is just helping the people. It's my passion, my dream, my purpose.
An important purpose as the weather turns colder.
And as Zaina mentioned, the Salvation Army Center of Hope is open tonight if someone needs shelter. The city of Augusta telling us its warming centers only open overnight when it's expected to drop below freezing. For now, they're open weekdays from 11 until 5. We have all this information for you on our WRDW app and online as well at WRDW.com.
It's a story all too familiar to the city of Augusta. People waiting hours for an ambulance in times of emergency when every second counts. Back over the summer, the city presented its own research on Gold Cross response times with the goal of making improvements. News 12's Kennedy Harris joins me now live from outside the ER at AUMC. Kennedy, it's been 6 months, and you say those improvements are still on hold.
Yeah, not much has happened since then, but Gold Cross says one bump in the road is here. Their ambulances are getting tied up at the hospital with non-emergent cases. That becomes worse during COVID surges, but city leaders are looking for solutions to fix the problem for good.
I've lived in other places. You call an ambulance and they're there almost as fast as you hang up, but not here.
John Engardia cares for three Augusta veterans out of his small personal care home.
Just a couple minutes, I'll be right with you.
Twice now, he's called for an ambulance, and he says he's waited more than 3 hours for them to arrive. He says the Gold Cross operator deemed his veteran's condition as non-emergent.
But I'm making that judgment when they're wrong. People can, and sometimes probably do, die.
In one case, the vet had sepsis, a life-threatening complication. He spent 10 days in the hospital recovering.
We all make mistakes in life, but most time when people make mistakes in this time, that it does cost someone their life.
Coming up in December, the city of Augusta will renew its contract with Gold Cross, but Hassan says there will be checks and balances this time around.
For the first time, we're in a good place to truly understand what we want.
They'll require a way to track Gold Cross response times and have periodic performance reviews. Gold Cross has already made some changes. They've added quick response vehicles to respond to emergencies, but they can't transport patients.
There's a level of care that needs to be provided, and we're doing everything that we can to ensure that level of care happens.
And they partnered with South Star to add about 3 more ambulances in the county. And there's a way you can help. Gold Cross is begging you not to call an ambulance for a ride to the ER if it's not an emergency. That just holds up ambulances here at the hospitals. So, for example, if your child has a stomach ache, that might not be a reason to call 911.
Certainly important information there. Thank you so much for that, Kennedy. The city tells us its contract negotiations with Gold Cross will start in October.
Some of our local school districts are struggling now to keep the doors open. In Richmond County, close to 30 schools have transitioned to virtual learning at some point since their return from winter break just last week. So here's a look at the latest COVID numbers for Richmond County schools. 122 student cases, 84 staff cases, and more than 600 students and 170 employees in quarantine right now. Comparing those numbers now to Columbia County schools, and Columbia County has not released quarantine numbers, but we know they reported 193 student cases and 56 cases in staff just last week. While the case counts are similar, Columbia County has not sent any students to learn from home yet. Here's News 12's Sloan O'Combe with how the district says they're navigating this new semester.
Columbia County mainly follows the state's recommendations. Exposure must be direct or close contact without a mask. Then you quarantine for 5 days, no symptoms, return after 5 days with a mask. If you're exposed outside of 3 feet, you can return to school as long as you wear a mask and monitor your symptoms. Richmond County follows the CDC's. Exposure is within 6 feet, quarantine 5 days unless you're boosted or had your second shot within 6 months. So as they transition to at-home learning because of teacher-related absences,
5 day window, that gives the school a chance to reset.
They clean and sanitize, give time to get test results, quarantine and isolate.
We're out of luck. And that's what it's like to work with the kids home. That's the 5-year-old.
But the transition still isn't perfect. Nafisa Young is indifferent. She wants fewer interruptions, but she wants to make sure her 5-year-old daughter and 10-year-old son with autism and lung disease are safe.
You know, parents have to get on board. We have to think about other people's children.
Ultimately, the districts and Nafisa are trusting you to make the safest decision for your kids and others by keeping them home when they are sick.
Sloan O'Combe reporting there. President Biden now with his own plan to help schools battle COVID. And today, the administration announcing it will be sending 10 million COVID tests to schools every month, doubling the number of testings that they're able to perform right now. Richmond County telling us the state is applying for those tests. Then they'll have more information on how they can get them. The county also says parents and schools are a partnership, so they are encouraging you to give your feedback on how you feel about how the district is handling COVID and its protocols.
Well, it still looks like winter weather will be possible for the CF the break.
Plus, continued coverage in the search for the person who shot and killed an 8-year-old girl in Augusta. What we know about the 3 people being held in connection to the case next.
Hi, I'm Mark Burke.
Just ask your asthma specialist about Dupixent.
It's the top priority case at the Richmond County Sheriff's Office, the search for who killed 8-year-old Aubrey Anthony in a drive-by shooting in Augusta. Just last night, we learned Grovetown police secured arrest warrants for these 3 people in connection to this murder investigation. News 12's Claire Allen spent the day digging into what we know about them and speaking with Bree's family about justice.
Arthur Anthony was there when the shots rang out.
She said, Daddy, they go to the horse. And I turned, pulled my phone out, the recorder playing with the horses, and it happened. It got fast.
Now, Anthony Redfield, Devontae McNeil, and Henry Beach are being held in connection to the shooting death of 8-year-old Aubrey Anthony. We know Beach has connections to the street gang LOE and was charged just last month with gang charges and weapon charges. He is now facing financial transaction card theft charges, with more expected to come. We also found a lengthy criminal history for Redfield, including felony murder and gun charges. He is being held right now for having a gun since he is a convicted felon. Aubrey's family is relieved investigators are working around the clock to find the shooter.
I was actually happy to see that they're working.
It really made me feel really good that I know they're going to work to get justice for my niece.
Bree's family says change needs to happen to put an end to gun violence in this community.
And what I want to see the system to do, crack down on these guns.
They're begging to put an end to the silence to help stop the violence.
Forget the street code. Forget all that, because that street code went out the window when they killed her.
Anybody come for it. Come for it. Please. Come for it.
Claire Allen, on your side.
And again, if you know anything about Aubrey or this Jeep Trailhawk you're seeing, you're asked to call the Richmond County Sheriff's Office. That number is 706-821-1080.
To weather now, as we have a look.
Still ahead, this small business has a pretty big order to fill. We'll take you to Barn. print shop is making national championship shirts for the dog fans here at home.
They're calling it the year of the dog, and why not? UGA fans soaking in every second of being the brand new national champions.
And we know plenty of you have already snagged your championship shirts, but there are plenty more on the way, and some of them are being made right here at home.
News 12's Will Vogt takes us to TNT Printwear in Barnwell to show us how it's done.
Barnwell, South Carolina's population is less than 5,000 people, but inside this Main Street print shop, the t-shirt population is more than triple that.
Georgia fans are eager to get one.
The machines at TNT Printwear have been going non-stop since Georgia won it all.
Pretty much since the game ended, we came in here and we've been running them straight.
Employees like Jacob Padgett are putting in long hours.
Only got a couple hours of sleep, little power naps, and then I'm right back in here.
Why? They've got an order to fill. More than 15,000 national championship t-shirts for Hanes. This small town print shop is supplying Walmarts and Sam's in our area.
They asked us if we could do it in time, and we told them, yeah, you know, we don't want to let anybody down. When this kind of opportunity comes around, we want to be reliable for this.
You can see what all that work has led to. They've got stacks and stacks of t-shirts ready to go.
You know, when they got big work like this, we like to take advantage of it.
He says it's worth the long days and nights for this small business to fill one big order. In Barnwell, Will Volk, on your side.
All right, thank you for that update, Will. Really cool that we have that t-shirt company here locally in the River region. As we mentioned earlier, we do have a first.